Is it all a coincidence, or is it all overwhelmingly connected? Why is NASA obsessed with naming space modules after ancient gods? Why did they land on the moon on Hitler's birthday at the exact same time when Orion's belt was 33 degrees above the landing site? According to ancient Egyptian beliefs, ceremonies performed directly under Orion's belt produce a sacred alignment, which allows humans to communicate directly with Osiris. Apollo 11 had landed at a specific day and a specific time where the three belt stars of Orion were on the horizon. And exactly 33 minutes after landing, Buzz Aldrin, the second man to walk on the moon, who was a 33-degree Scottish Rite Freemason, was actually performing a ceremony on board the lunar module with Neil Armstrong. Coincidence? We think not. Wait, do you hear this? When Neil Armstrong said those immortal words as he set foot on the moon,
I'm at the foot of the ladder. The lamb footbeds are only depressed in the surface about 1 or 2 inches. I'm going to step off the lamb now. It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Was what he meant an actual reference to the ceremony, and has the lack of activity since actually been a waiting game? Perhaps the Great Leap has, in fact, still to come. Would it surprise you to learn that what is found at Palenque in the Temple of Inscriptions is actually the engraving of an ancient spacecraft on Lord Pakal's legendary sarcophagus? We have spoken about this before, but it is still not being properly appreciated as to the significance of this thing. This is a smoking gun, you know. This is clearly an advanced machine and possibly a spacecraft. Pakal is leaving the Earth in a chariot in this depiction. If you consider the standing stones and obelisk all over the planet and the connection to ancient energy sources and astronomical alignments, and then consider that on the moon of Mars there is something similar on tiny moon Phobos, then consider that these are there to draw energy like pylons. They are ancient energy sources from a grid. In Heliopolis, there was once around 48 huge obelisks that have since been moved to cities all around the world. Why? Well, because they tried to harness the energy across great distances, just like what was achieved in the ancient past. One of these ancient monuments is found at St. Peter's Square, which ironically is not a square but a circle, and the circle represents a symbol for the Anunnaki. The ancient monuments are examples of advanced technology. In ancient texts, it is documented that the massive stones at Baalbek were actually landing and launch pads for spacecraft. Not the Roman structures we see today, but the enormous stone blocks of the foundations that are of impossible proportion by today's standards. The ruins that we consider impossible are the ruins of the gods, a time on Earth which is considered the golden period by the Greeks. The gods, however, were very real. They were the operators of these advanced constructions, and the activity in which was witnessed propelled these beings to immortal status that we still speak about to this day. It's not myth. It happened, and the ancient places all over the earth are backed up with documentation, many different styles of text covering hundreds of thousands of pieces worldwide. It is obvious, when closely considered, this massively outweighs any other scenario. It's a similar case at Pumapunku, where there are gigantic blocks with some weighing over 800 tons. Who made this place? Well, it is foretold it was gods, the same gods who descended to the Earth from space. Sites like this are not scarce across our planet, if you consider what a holy place is and its relation to why it is holy, then you could be forgiven for making the connection of advanced beings that inhabited this Earth in the distant past and eventually left this planet and took their equipment with them. It's crazy, but it's true, guys. What these places could have been is both space stations and mission control centers and what we refer to as the ancient space program. Pumapunku was the control center, and Baalbek was a landing pad. Look at the gigantic hole in the ground at Chichen Itza. The Mayans thought this was a reservoir for fresh water, but this anomalous hole in the ground that was used for many purposes by this civilization looks more like a deliberately cut hole. For what purpose? To launch massive objects into outer space, of course. Would it surprise you to learn that ruins from previous NASA space programs closely match these ancient sites? If NASA were copying ancient knowledge and technology, and we could prove it, then surely that would be a showstopper, a complete game changer, right? One of the true enigmas of the region of Teotihuacan is the liquid mercury that is known to exist underneath the monumental structure. Mercury is, of course, a conductor in electrical components and obviously essential in the fabrication of aerospace materials. An ancient civilization like the Mayans would have had no use for this liquid because it is a metal that only a technologically sophisticated civilization would have used. In other words, a much more ancient civilization, and indeed, you guessed it, what is referred to as the gods. Here's the thing about mercury. If you put it into a vortex, spin and electrolyze it, what you get is the result of ant-gravitational technology, just like the Giza Plateau. We don't know who built Teotihuacan, when or for what reason. If we have the theory correct with this, then all we don't know is how it all worked exactly, but it is all connected. We see an advanced society that reached these heights of technological advancement, and then they disappeared. Isn't that a strange, similar pattern that is developing here, do you think? What Teotihuacan probably was an ancient command post of a space station. The evidence is looking right at us in the face. It's obvious ancient civilizations left this planet in order to survive the human race, but the question is, why are we here now? Why were we chosen to be left behind? If the cataclysm is destined to happen at 26,000 year intervals, then we must strive to go to Mars, to terraform the red planet in order to extend human technological advancements and preserve the knowledge. We can all use an iPhone, but how many of us can build one from scratch? If a cataclysm happens with no plans in place, then it's reset time again. It is more than probable, you know, that NASA and the secret space program have acquired ancient knowledge and are actively looking to harness this knowledge in order to one day leave the Earth and join our ancient ancestors wherever they may be. The signs are literally everywhere. The writing is literally carved onto the walls. Time to wake up. The ancient sites are maps to the stars. What do you guys think of this anyway? Comments below, and as always, thank you for watching. It was once the largest city in the Western Hemisphere. The history, origins, power, and decline remain unknown in modern society. At one point, it was the home to up to a 500,000 people and had a huge urban core. Just like every civilization on Earth, the decline was swift. In fact, it was so fast of a decline that they could not even document their collapse. But they never documented their rise to power either. And get this, there is no evidence whatsoever that they had any sort of ruler or government. So who was calling the shots? Who masterminded the construction? Was it aliens? There are certain mysterious things about Teotihuacan that experts the world over agree. It is more than baffling. Wait till you hear this. There are astonishing similarities between the Great Pyramid at Giza and the Sun Pyramid at Teotihuacan. The Pyramid of the Sun is exactly half as tall as the Pyramid of Giza, and the Temple of the Sun, the Temple of the Moon, and the Temple of Quetzalcoatl are in the same layout as Orion's Belt, exactly the same layout as the pyramids at Giza. Every building at Teotihuacan has mica embedded in the building work. The most local source of mica is found no less than 3,000 miles away in Brazil. Mica is stable when exposed to electricity, light, moisture, and extreme temperatures. It has superior electrical properties as an insulator and as a dielectric, and can support an electrostatic field while dissipating minimal energy in the form of heat, and is thermally stable at 500 Celsius. The fact there is no local source of mica and the fact that they imported it from so far away is just mind-boggling. How was this done? Why was this done?
Now, if we were to point out the fact that Teotihuacan resembles a giant circuit board, you would say that we were crazy. But it does. With two large processor chips, the Sun Pyramid and the Moon Pyramid, and the underground channels that link the pyramid city are lined with electrical insulator. Crazy, right? But what if it is true? What if this is a place that an alien civilization chose to leave a massive map for future civilizations to build the foundation for a computer circuit board? What if these types of sites across the globe on every continent are somehow giant maps for us to build some sort of super technology? This would mean that almost every country in the world would have to cooperate with each other to build each piece of the board, then fit each piece together. Maybe it is the map to build the technology for an interstellar ship, and the destination is Orion's Belt. Maybe it is an invitation for civilizations on Earth that when we get past our indifferences on this world, we go to theirs. Another strange thing about this ancient site is the fact that it can only be truly appreciated from the sky. Much like other ancient sites like the Nazca Lines, for example, the layout is clearly for a higher purpose that we are struggling to even comprehend in modern times. Along the Avenue of the Dead, the pyramids there align in perfect distance of each of the orbits of our planets in our solar system. And perhaps most significant is the fact that the large pyramid of the Sun is positioned at the center of the other structures, reflecting the fact that the Sun is at the center of our solar system and that the planets revolve around it. We don't know why this ancient wonder was constructed. We don't know how it was even done. We are left to speculate its true purpose, but one thing is for sure, and that is the fact that there is much more to this place than we are yet to imagine. The answer could lie in the stars, the moon, or the sun, or maybe it is staring right at us and we cannot even see it because it is too obvious. Something along those lines anyway. Do you believe that the evidence just keeps stacking up in favor of the ancient world being much more advanced than we ever thought possible? We could even be underestimating the true age of these structures by many thousands of years. We would love to hear your thoughts. Comment below, guys. Thanks for watching, and thank you for subscribing to our channel.